I do see Christopher here going, she has been serving this whole time. And I think this is where I'm going to basically throw a little bit of fire or a little bit of fuel on this fire and say, I don't think that's the case. I think she was looking for another way. I genuinely think that Sylvanas, even though she had made the deal with Zaval to come back after seeing what the realms of death look like, I think Sylvanas was hoping that she could usher in a new age. She could train the Forsaken and the Horde and the Alliance to be the army that takes on the Shadowlands and destroys it. I do believe that the deaths of Varian Wrynn and the deaths of Vol'jin is what made her realize that none of this can ever happen. When the gods when the gods have decided something, nothing you do matter. Like at that point, it doesn't matter what you do. It doesn't matter if you want to decide, I'm going to go this way. If the gods decided, no, motherfucker, you're going this way, you're going this way. Whether you want to go that way or not doesn't really matter to you, right? The gods have decided. And that's how she realized, okay, I must follow him because clearly we don't have free will within this universe. Only to realize that, well, the jailer is going to take what pretense of free will we have and he's going to just go, nope. He's going to snuff that out immediately and say, there is no more free will.
And that's a big theme as well for the jailer's actions so far, before we get into the whole serving conundrum. The jailer and his domination magic hasn't actually been used. And I know people are going to freak out like, oh, Anduin was dominated. Yeah. But was he, though? Everything we have seen so far from the jailer, from everything in the Shadowlands so far, you've had to willingly submit to it. They can't force you to do it.
Okay.
You have to willingly make the choice to go down that path. They may lie to you about what that path is and what it will entail, but you still have to openly walk through that door yourself. And I think that's going to be a big part of the book. I think that's going to be a big part of Anduin's goodbye cinematic, is the reveal that he did actually agree to this plan. He just didn't realize what that would actually entail. But you have to agree before the jailer can actually do anything. And yet everyone's calling him the villain because he's forcing this on you. No, he's just lying to you about what the truth behind the deal is. He's hiding the fine print from you. But you have to make that deal. You have to sign your name away on the dotted line before he'll do anything.
I agree with your premise. I disagree with your statement that domination magic have not been used. It is possible that Anduin agreed at first to serve. It is clear that now Anduin is under the control of domination magic.
So obviously I use the term slightly differently. Like domination magic as a school has been used. But domination as in forcibly dominating somebody hasn't been. Submit to be controlled. It's not forced on you. Submitted to it. Still controlled.
Just to say, Evalius actually points something out here, which is very true. Jaina, Thrall, and Bolvar was made to serve without giving any sort of, we're willing to go to our knees and have our eyes turn blue.
See, now that's the changing point, right? He was fully powered up at this point. He had all the sigils. He had all the power.
Okay.
He didn't need your cooperation at this point. Whereas previously, without that power, or with only one of the sigils, as the Covenants have had, you have to submit. You actually have to agree to it. That's one of the kind of contingencies put in place by the Makers and their flawed design. And maybe that's the flaw.
You
have a choice.
You see, while we're talking about domination magic, I'd like to posit something that I'm working on in a video. It's a video that I have planned. I'm probably going to start making it tomorrow. Domination magic did not belong to the Eternal Ones. Not at all. It's not their magic. It's not magic that they're even allowed to use. It's a magic that is used only as a last resort. It's a magic that they use to stop Zaval. Now, the reason I say this is going to become apparent when I go into all of the detail once I make the video. But I will say this, there's a moment where you go to finally discover the Primus, and Zaval tells him, you bound me with domination, but now it is my weapon to wield, right? Which suggests that he didn't always...
turned his chains into a weapon.
Yeah, he didn't always have domination magic. Now, if you look at the sigil, Zaval's sigil, and this is huge, by the way, and so many people sort of saw the sigil when... oh my god, and then stop thinking. Right? Just, yeah, oh my God.
It was too huge.
Ooh, a bunny. Right? That's sort of what a lot of people did. Oh my God, look at that sigil. Ooh, a bunny, a butterfly. What the fuck's going on? Am I playing WoW? No, I guess I'll play some Final Fantasy instead. Whatever the case might be, but a lot of people miss that. The sigil is the sign of infinity. It's the Ouroboros sign, the snake eating its own tail. The beginning is the end is the beginning, the Alpha, the Omega. That sigil is his, Bolvar confirms it. The jailer took it back, as if it always belonged to him. That sigil was his. He is the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end of the Shadowlands. He was once the ruler of the Shadowlands, and yet he did not have control over domination magic, because they used domination to bind him in the maw, but now it is his weapon to use. So what Zuval ultimately did is, while the rest of the Eternal Ones rested on their laurels, while the rest of the Eternal Ones effectively, basically, went around playing God. And I have sort of a theory about their sigils as well, just by the way. The Primus says that should Zuval get his hands on all five sigils, he will truly become unstoppable. I believe that the sigils allow them to draw power from their covenants. This is why the Primus says each covenant will have to find their own purpose again, their new purpose, right? And then will reforge the sigils. So the sigil draws power from the purpose of the covenant. That's how they've been using these sigils, basically growing fat on anima. Not he, though. Zuval did not have access to a sigil, so he could not draw power from the Maw. He could not draw power from any of the other covenants. Instead, he learned how to master the one magic that does not require anima, the magic of the First Ones. Domination magic. You see, and he managed he managed to basically turn that into a super weapon. Not even they had this power. Remember, to bind him, they had to use the combined might of all of them, including their covenants, in order to bind him into the Maw. So it's clear that they sort of understood domination magic and how to kind of bind him, but they didn't understand exactly how it needs to be used. He mastered it. And that's where I believe this entire domination magic story is going to take a major turn to a completely different place than what most people think. And I'll just sort of throw this in there as well, because this is actually a bigger part of something that I see now sort of happening throughout the entirety of World of Warcraft. The community, at least. Everyone sort of going, bruh, he said the Maker's flawed design. There are people on Azeroth that refers to the Makers, the Titans, as the Makers. Therefore, he's referring to the Makers, the Titans. The Titans are the First Ones.
Yeah. There's a lot of reason and a lot of things lining up to say that would be the case. But there's also a lot that lines up and kind of argues that it wouldn't be the case as well. And the problem is they're all coming from the same source, which is rather annoying. Pick a lane.
I genuinely think that people are missing the meaning behind the word maker. When the dwarfs refer to the Titans as makers, or when the Titan constructs refer to the Titans as makers, they are not lying. Their makers are indeed the Titans. Their makers are not the First Ones. They had nothing to do with the First Ones. Their makers are the Titans. When Zuval refers to the makers, he's referring to his makers. So the ones who made him. Doesn't have to be the Titans. It could be. I'm not saying that the Titans couldn't be the First Ones. It would be horrible storytelling, but I'm sure Blizzard would be able to smash that one out in an afternoon. I'm just saying...
We can smash it out now. I've got the line that Blizzard will use for that.
Okay.
Is that they're not the First Ones of the universe. They're the First Ones of the New Order of the Shadowlands. They are the makers of the flawed design.
Yeah.
The system in the Shadowlands that doesn't work with the sigils and shit like that. That they're the First Ones. They're the First Ones that came in from the outside to change their way.
Mm-hmm.
Done. Easy. Not the First Ones of the universe, not the First Ones made by the Clockmaker, not the first, like, archangels, so to speak. They're just the first outside force they've ever met.
You see, this is not even canon yet, and I'm fucking triggered. This is not even canon yet, and I'm fucking triggered. I definitely don't want that to be the story.
No, me neither. Like, people get, like, bent out of shape, and I've seen, again, this in the comments so many times. Yeah. Theories we come up with are not necessarily things we would like to see. If we only ever talked about things we would like to see, it would get very boring.
Yeah,
but
true.
This is where we can theorize it going, and with how Blizzard's story writing is going currently, and how truncated a lot of storylines are getting, it would make a lot of sense for them to just cut like 17 corners and go, yeah, Titans, first ones they ever saw.
You see, the reason I believe that people are wrong when they think that the Titans are the first ones, we have the line, Zuval is a Titan +++. So you're telling me the Titans go in, they make their own being, and they go, you know what, just for shits and giggles, let's make this one stronger than what we are, right? Let's see what happens.
See, again, you've missed my point again as well. They didn't make the Eternal Ones. They're not their
makers. No, I understand what you're saying. You're saying they came in, conquered the Shadowlands, and basically subverted the way the Shadowlands used to function, and basically made it so that now they all function the same. Sure, possible. But then how the fuck did they conquer Zuval? How did
he
even allow
the Eternal
that?
Ones. And a magic they didn't have full access to. We've explained multiple times before that the Titans have a very limited form of domination magic themselves. They use binding magics to bind forces together with those seals that we see all over the place.
Yeah.
So combine that with the Primus and his big brain strategy, as well as the power from the other Eternal Ones, it would be enough to bind, or at least unlock to a certain extent, domination magic to bind Zuval. And funnily enough, he's bound completely, very much like we see Titans do to other Titans.
Ladies and gentlemen, I do hope that you enjoyed this clip from the Sunday Night Chill Show. If you enjoyed it and you want to watch it live, the link to the main channel will be in the description down below. And of course, remember to slap a like on this video, hit that subscribe button, and smash that bell. It does help out. To all of the patrons, thank you so much for your monthly support. It does mean the world to me. And of course, it makes streams like this one possible. So from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank you. Consider becoming a patron. Link in the description down below. Ladies and gentlemen, as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace out, fam.